Cloud platforms are crucial for data science. Today, I'll give you an introduction to using the cloud for data science. And make sure you watch till the very end, where I'll share a couple of learning resources that I use to keep myself up to date with the latest cloud platforms. And this will help you set yourself apart when you're applying for data science jobs. I'm Samanvay, a data scientist living in Sydney, Australia. A while back, I talked about the best laptop for data science. And if you recall correctly, I recommended laptops without a GPU. Which is obviously essential for machine learning algorithms. So it turns out that in the commercial data science world, you'll rarely use your personal laptop for training models. In fact, most of the time, you won't even have a training data set on your local computer. Everything in the commercial world is done on the cloud. A cloud is basically a range of computers and services that you access over the internet. These computers usually sit in super secret locations under high security. Just imagine a whole array of computers in a massive warehouse with state-of-the-art cooling technology and no monitors. There are three benefits to using the cloud. The first is that you have access to a large amount of computing power and storage, along with a number of services with the click of a button. The second is that it's generally cheaper per unit of power than your local computers due to economies of scale. The third is that the cloud is more reliable and secure than your local computers. And this is especially useful when you're trying to train models over 1 or 2 weeks. According to the 2021 Stack Overflow developer surveys, the top three most used cloud platforms are Amazon Web Services, Google Cloud Platform, and Azure. Together, they own the majority of the market share when it comes to cloud technologies. Personally, I've used Amazon Web Services and Google Cloud Platform. And comment below if you have used any of these cloud technologies. Now, let's talk a little bit about what I've used the cloud for so that it gives you more of a practical idea on how it can be used in data science. The first is storing data. So in all the companies that I've worked at, all of the data sets were always stored on the cloud. So this is on S3 buckets on Amazon Web Services or cloud storage on Google Cloud Platform. And I believe the equivalent is blob storage on Azure. You can imagine all of these storage services as big hard drives with essentially unlimited capacities that you pay for per gigabyte that you use. The second use case is running application. So if we had an ETL application or a data processing application, it would always be running on the cloud because these applications were part of an automated pipeline, which would be triggered based on data from an external source. For example, if the user sent data through their mobile app or through the web. As you can imagine, these are processes that you really don't want to be running manually because it's just so repetitive. The third use case is running models. Depending on the size of your data set, training a model can take a couple of days. And you can imagine how it's not exactly feasible on your local laptop. I mean, if you were to train a model on your local laptop, you'd have to make sure that the laptop is always awake and it's not plugged out of power. So instead, why not just use a computer on the cloud, which is almost always on and a lot more reliable than your local computer. So you can just start the model training on that computer and check the progress periodically instead of sitting glued to the laptop trying to monitor the progress. Computers on the cloud are always available and ready for use, apart from downtime every now and then. But this can fluctuate anywhere from 7 hours a month to half a minute, depending on how much cash you're willing to spend and your application requirements. Now that you've got an idea on what the cloud is for, let me talk you through some of the learning resources that can help you upskill yourself when it comes to learning about cloud platforms and how to use them.
For learning Amazon Web Services, I would recommend doing the edX online course for AWS. You can start off by doing the AWS Cloud Practitioners course. You can do all these courses for free, but if you want a certificate, you'll need to pay $100, which isn't worth it. Not many people look at these when they're hiring. Along with the course, I'd recommend getting an AWS account and using their free tier services. As a new user, you have access to 12 months of free tier membership, which which allows you to use the most popular services on AWS for free. For example, you can use SageMaker for 250 hours and have 750 free hours on a Linux machine. For Google Cloud Platform, QuickLabs is the best. I've used it at my current job to learn all about GCP. This platform follows the ethos of learning by doing, which you all know is my absolute favorite. For each lab, you'll get temporary access to the Google Cloud Platform where you can apply what you learn. It's truly an engaging way of learning. There's also a skills challenge being run by Google Cloud, which gives you 30-day free access to learn Google Cloud Platform. You've got the option of choosing from four different tracks, including an ML and AI track, which is amazing. Learning Azure is similar to learning AWS. You can learn about the basics from their website, which has multiple training courses. Then you can sign up for a free account, which gives you access to the most popular services for 12 months.
You don't need to do courses on all three platforms. Just pick one and get started, because whatever you learn in that one course, it'll be easily transferable to the other cloud platforms. You should focus on learning how to store files, how to configure and use computers on the cloud, and how to use the dedicated AI platforms on the cloud service. So this is SageMaker on AWS, Vertex AI on GCP, and Azure AI Platform on Microsoft. Hope these resources help you get started on your cloud journey. If you enjoyed the video, then be sure to smash the like button, and I'll see you next time.